In this video, we present a visual tutorial on project scheduling. Let's see 4 steps for an effective project scheduling. 1. How to identify project tasks. 2. How to estimate project duration, resources, and cost. 3. How to arrange project activities in a sequence. 4. How to optimize project schedule. I'm sure you'll be able to understand the PMBOK much better. Here is the right place to improve your project management skills. Keep watching and subscribe. Welcome to Practical Business Analysis. My name is Américo Cunha. Learn fast, solve problems, make good decisions. Project planning is an art of anticipation. Yes, the art of preparing for something in advance. The visualization of future events. First step, identify project tasks. The project tasks can be identified and organized with the support of a tool called WBS, Work Breakdown Structure. In the WBS, we organize the tasks into manageable groups that can be by project phases, deliverables, or by subject matter. The WBS Work Breakdown Structure is like an assembling kit diagram from which you can develop your project plan. In the first level, you have the main sections, main work phase, or main deliverable. These project sections are then further broken down into tasks or work packages that can be assigned to a single person to handle. In the WBS chart, these are the lowest level, the smallest project units in which all plan will be developed. In summary, the WBS takes the project outcome expected by the client and arranges it in manageable components. Usually, projects can be divided into phase, deliverables, or subject matter. For instance, an IT project is divided into phases, such as planning, requirements, system design, development, testing, and implementation. A wedding event project can be divided per subject matter. For instance, invitations, ceremony, venue, gathering, bridal, etc. Step 2. Estimate task duration, resources, and cost. Time and resource estimates are a big part of the schedule because they help to determine how long tasks should take. The estimating activity is very critical to the project. The project manager should try to get the best advice from experienced people on the job and check as well actual duration of previous projects. Each task of the WBS lowest level are evaluated. For each one, first, we try to estimate the effort, work hour, that will take to finish the task. Two things should be taken in consideration to determine the task duration: the effort, work hours, and resource availability. For instance, the project manager should understand if the person in charge for a task will be working full-time or part-time. Full-time dedication leads to a shorter duration. Step 3. Arrange tasks in a sequence. Putting tasks in a logical work sequence is the next challenge to develop the project schedule. First, you have to find out the relationships between tasks and identify which task must be done before the other task. If a task has to be done before another, it is called predecessor. After, it's time to determine the possible start date for each task. This can be done by computing times on the project network. The project network technique is called precedence diagramming method, PDM. The PDM allows us to define the starting and finishing times for each activity, the total project duration, and the critical path. The critical path is the shortest period in which the project can be completed. After the times calculation, you can find a better way to show the task time. The most common way is the Gantt chart. The Gantt chart illustrates the start and finish times for dates for each task in a type of bar chart.
It's like a project calendar. Each task has a bar showing its start and finish dates. The fourth scheduling step is when we try to optimize the project schedule. The three most important optimization strategies are balancing resource workload. It is the activity to make sure that each team member has a realistic work hour planned in period. Then it's always good to verify if you can reduce the project duration. You can try to allocate extra resource for a task. Also, you need to evaluate the execution risks and maybe accommodate buffers between tasks. So the project starts with an idea, sometimes not well defined. In the project charter, the idea became more realistic. During the planning, the project team work on the idea to define the scope, to define project boundaries, and other important aspects. Then the project is divided into logical pieces and well-defined tasks or work packets. All the planning is developed based on the tasks. For each task, durations, resources, costs, sequence, and risks are defined. Once the project planning is approved, the project execution starts. The project team works on each task according to the schedule. In the end, the project product is delivered, and hopefully according to the client's initial idea. In this video, we saw 4 steps for effective project scheduling. 1. Identify project tasks. 2. Estimate duration, resources, and cost. 3. Arrange activities in a sequence. 4. Optimize project schedule. It was just an introduction. My intention was to provide just an overview and help you to understand the project scheduling activities as they are presented in technical books, such as PMBOK. We worked hard to help you to get better marks, be prepared for job interviews, and excel in work meetings. You can send your questions in the comment area below. I will be pleased to answer all of them. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to Americo e-Learning.